Hello everyone and welcome to the basics of IT apps. Up to the last session, up to the last video, we have successfully erected the simple structure, as you can see in here, this 3D model. Now we are about to model the remaining structure. Okay, so here we will use some special commands like replicate. Okay, so first we will draw the beam and the slab for this much segment. As you can see, my cursor is moving along with. Okay, so to start with, I will draw a beam over here. Select a beam from the drop down list. I require 230 by 450. Okay, so select or draw a beam like this from here to here. Then from here to here, say, and this beam is resting onto this. Okay, so here already beam is there, so I am closing to draw beam. Okay, now we need to draw a slab, and you can see that this slab is irregular slab. Okay, and if you observe one more thing, that here what happened, if you go to the 3D model and rotate it, you will be able to see that beam is being drawn only for one story. Why? Because here one story is selected. So we will delete this beam again. Select all story. We need this work on to be on all story. Again, we will draw a beam from here to here, then here, then here. Okay. So now you can see that the beam is drawn on all surfaces. Okay. So on all floors. Now we need to draw a slab. If we want to draw irregular slab, you have to select this icon. This is for drawing an irregular floor. I'll select this. Then again, you have to select a slab as of SLB 150. And while drawing an irregular slab, to have a uniform load distribution over the beam which are supporting this slab, we have to add a slab or we have to attach the slab with the midpoint of every beam. But you can see here we are unable to snap the midpoint of every beam. So don't worry, go to draw menu. In draw menu, there is a snap option. Under a snap option, I need to activate this line ends and midpoints. Okay. For being now, I will activate this only. You can activate other also if required. So here intersections and line ends and midpoints, I am activating and clicking on apply, close. Okay, now if I start drawing a slab with this point, from here I need to snap midpoint. See, I got the midpoint of this beam, then here, then here. Again, midpoint of this beam, we will get here, yeah, and closing it. Yes, perfectly. You can see that slab and beam is drawn for these two segments. Now, what we need to do? We need to replicate this, whatever we have drawn, throughout. The selector properties which you need to replicate. So I have selected this slab. I want not this side beam. I want this beam to be everywhere. Of course, this beam and this beam. Okay. Now what will happen if we replicate that what we have selected, when this will come to this end, when last segment will be formed, This beam will overlap on already existing beam. Okay, so to avoid this, what I am doing, I am deleting this beam. We'll delete this beam. Now select the things that we need to replicate. We'll replicate this, this, and this. Okay, now go to edit, then go to replicate. Four options are available over here. As you know that we do not have to replicate it linearly, that we don't have to replicate in X or Y or Z direction, but yeah, we want to replicate it radially. So we will select radially, then center or rotate about point, which point. So I would like to specify it, and we'll click on pick one point on model, then go to this center. Automatically it will pick its coordinate. Okay, then incremental data. Okay, so angle, by an angle I know that each segment is having or sustained an angle of 15 degree, so this will be a 30 degree total. Okay, 30 degree. How many numbers do I need? So in 3/4 circle, there will be 9 segments, out of which one is already there. Okay, so it means that I need to enter here 8. Okay, and don't delete the original object and click on apply. If you can see that as I am clicking, so we know that ETAB generates everything anti-clockwise. So it starts generating, see, if you can see, it starts generating anti-clockwise, but I want to generate these selected segments in clockwise direction. So what I will do, I will enter here a minus 30 degree. Okay, now go to this apply. See, we are getting perfect as what we need. So click, hit the apply button, and at last, I will close this. We will delete this beam and will draw from as it is. It is 230 by 600. We will draw from here to here. Okay, now it is complete. Now again we will add a cylindrical column to the structure. So again I will go to the draw column. Okay, property, in property I'll select circular column, which we have already defined. So we will add this at a specific intervals, say over here as shown in the diagram over here. Okay, close, have a look at this. Yes, we have added the everything that which were asked in the plan. So in this way your plan is ready. So this was all about modeling irregular structures.